This is my duty now. This is what Shaitan said. This is what I want to do. Each and every one I want to misguide. Allah said, and I swear by my own izzah that I will continue to forgive them as long as they turn to me in repentance. You do what you want. I will continue to forgive as long as they turn to me and ask me in repentance. Allah Himself asks us to repent to Him. أَفَلَا يَتُوبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ Why don't they repent to Allah? Why don't they seek Allah's forgiveness? For Allah is Ghafoor and Rahim. Allah tells us in the Quran, if you repent, it is for your own good. فَإِنْ يَتُوبُوا يَكُوا خَيْرًا لَهُمْ If you do tawbah, it is for your own good. Allah says in the Quran, يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُبَيِّنَ لَكُمْ وَيَهْدِيَكُمْ سُنَنَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَيَتُوبَ عَلَيْكُمْ Allah wants to accept your repentance. Allah wants to do so. We only have to show the repentance and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept it. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also reminded us of how much Allah loves to forgive. When Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what should I say on Laylatul Qadr? On the holiest night of the year, what should I say? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you should say, O Allah, you are the Afu, the one who erases sins. And you love to forgive sins. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa. Allah loves to forgive sins. Allah loves to forgive sins. So, O Allah, you are the one who is Afu, and you love to forgive. Therefore, forgive my sins as well. In fact, brothers and sisters, one of the biggest sins that we can do is to give up hope of Allah's forgiveness. To claim that Allah cannot forgive me is a bigger sin than any other sin that you have done. Let me repeat that. To claim that Allah cannot forgive me, I am too sinful. There is no point in repenting. Allah cannot forgive me, I am too sinful. This very claim of yours is a bigger sin than anything else you might have done as a Muslim. No questions about it. Why and how so? O Muslim, no matter how sinful you are, do you think that you alone, single-handedly, have committed so many sins that you can encompass Allah's mercy? That Allah's mercy cannot forgive you? That you can challenge the Rahman and the Rahim? That you can say, I am so sinful, Allah's Rahmah. Who are you and what are your sins in comparison to the mercy of Allah? To claim that I am so sinful, Allah cannot forgive me. That arrogance is a greater crime and a greater sin than any other sin that you might have done. And that is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the biggest of all sins is shirk. To worship another god, to worship an idol. The biggest of all sins is shirk and to give up hope of Allah's mercy and to say that Allah cannot forgive me. These are the biggest sins, to commit shirk with Allah and then to claim Allah cannot forgive me. To claim Allah cannot forgive you, you are limiting the mercy of Allah. You are limiting the forgiveness of Allah and you are claiming single-handedly that you and your sins are more powerful than Allah and His mercy. And that in and of itself, as we said, is a greater sin than any other sin you might possibly have committed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala challenges us in the Quran, reminds us in the Quran, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقُنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا Say, O my servants who have committed sins against themselves, O you who have lived your life in evil, O you who have not prayed regularly, O you who are involved in drugs and women and alcohol and all of the evils on earth, do not give up hope of Allah's mercy. This is a verse in the Quran addressed to sinners, addressed to evil people, evil Muslims. O you who are sinners, do not give up hope of Allah's mercy. Allah can forgive all sins, no exceptions. Even the sin of shirk, Allah forgives it when somebody repents. Even the sin of shirk, Allah forgives it when somebody repents. And how do you repent from shirk? by restating your shahada and never returning to that shirk again. Even the sin of shirk, Allah can forgive it. If a person converts to Islam, his shirk is forgiven, is it not? If a Hindu, a Christian, any person accepts Islam, the shirk he has done is all forgiven. Similarly, if a Muslim commits shirk, he must say the shahada again. And with that shahada, repent, and even that shirk will be forgiven. How about the sins lesser than that? Brothers and sisters, there is no question that Allah's forgiveness and Allah's mercy can encompass all of the creation and even more so. You all know of the famous hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where he said that the Prophet Musa alaihi salam was with the famous Khidr. Khidr, by the way, was a prophet of Allah. Some people think he was some mystical saint. This is not true. Khidr was another prophet, and Musa was also a prophet, and the two prophets were sent to different peoples. It is not possible for a wali of Allah to be higher than a prophet of Allah. When Musa is coming to learn from Khidr, this means Khidr is already a prophet, and Khidr has knowledge that Musa does not have, and that is why Khidr did what he did, and that is another topic in and of itself. When Musa was with Khidr, and Khidr was riding on that ship that the story is mentioned in the Quran, he dipped his finger into the ocean and pulled it out. And he asked Musa, how much water do you think my finger decreased from the ocean? Musa said, nothing. What has your water decreased from the ocean? And Khidr replied, such is the mercy of Allah. Such is the mercy of Allah and the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that all of the creation cannot detract, cannot subtract, cannot reduce the mercy and the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just like my finger cannot reduce the ocean's water. Such is the mercy of Allah that no person should ever despair of it. But the question arises, how then, how do we go about this process of tawbah? What is the proper methodology of tawbah? The proper methodology of tawbah is very simple. A number of steps, memorize them.